Nine News reporter Annalise Bolt is at the Windsor Bridge for us tonight. Annalise, what's the situation as we go to air?
Pete, it's difficult to believe, but that's the Windsor Bridge behind me right now, completely swallowed by the Hawkesbury River. The river peaked here earlier today at levels we haven't seen in 44 years. Those levels are starting to come down now slowly, but that major flood level is expected to stay in place until late tomorrow afternoon. Locals here just hoping it won't get any worse. As the gauges along the Hawkesbury Nepean disappeared, residents in suburb after suburb had no option but to get out fast. At Windsor, the locals know the evacuation route off by heart.
Third time this year.
And it's clearly getting too much.
I'm just upset that this has happened. The police have done a very good job.
50,000 people are tonight under evacuation orders and warnings.
If those evacuation orders are in place, please leave.
A stubborn and powerful east coast low dropping an enormous volume of rain.
Some locations across New South Wales have seen, 800 millimetres over the last 4 days, and many over 500.
The forecast for the Hawkesbury and Nepean rivers was underdone. This was the Windsor Bridge yesterday. It wasn't expected to get a whole lot worse. But 24 hours later, the flooding was significant. The Hawkesbury River peaking at just under 14 metres, the highest this year.
Everyone who's been impacted before will be impacted for at least a third time, and some new people are going to feel it as well this time.
That left the RFS and SES knocking on doors around suburbs like McGrath's Hill to evacuate surprised residents. Many chose not to go. The evacuation order was clearly justified. McGrath's Hill isolated quickly by the Brown River water. Others just ended up getting caught. The water's rising too fast and the information coming too slow.
When the evacuation order came out, it was too late for us to leave.
The speed in which this flood has surprised the people of the Hawkesbury has been matched only by how quickly it has been declared a natural disaster, meaning financial assistance becomes immediately available. The declaration is for 23 local government areas in New South Wales. The funding is accessed through Service New South Wales, in areas stretching from Shoalhaven in the south through to the central coast and out to Cessnock and Lithgow.
This is obviously the first stage, a very important first stage, to opening up funding and further support for individuals, families and communities.
The Deputy PM, Richard Miles, toured the Hawkesbury with the 100 troops working in the disaster zone.
This time around, that in terms of immediate response and the coordination with the Commonwealth Government has been very strong.
Anthony Albanese landing in Perth to criticism of his travel schedule after 8 days in Europe.
My heart goes out to people who've suffered again and again and again and again.
The PM well aware with tens of thousands underwater, he can't waste any time.
Tomorrow morning I'll be on the ground with the Premier of New South Wales.
Annalise Bolt, Nine News.
Almost a dozen holidaymakers have become stranded in the Blue Mountains. A zip line is being used by RFS to bring supplies to them in the Megalong Valley after they were cut off by flooding on Sunday. Three campers were extracted this morning, but the weather turned, forcing rescuers to abandon the operation. Eight remain stuck, including two campers who are emergency service personnel on holiday from Victoria. It's been nearly half a century since parts of the city's south have experienced a disaster like this. Tonight there's more looming danger, with flash flooding still a threat.
Down the stairs and into a pool. The kitchen, living room and bedroom all washed out. The laundry still on the line.
Basically the creek just went straight through, out into the street.
Warren McWhirter and his family are now dry, but the water has left a lasting mark on their home.
Bottom levels are right off. Everything's gone. Floors, gyprock, walls, electrical.
Down the road, Mitch Leto is feeling the same pain.
Half the house is gone. Everything in the garage, there's thousands of dollars of tools, motorbikes in the garage, stuff like that, that's all gone. Cars are gone.
forced to rescue his 77-year-old mum, Rosemary, trapped in her flooding caravan.
I had to be piggybacked out.
Warranora hasn't seen flooding like this since 1988.
We did have to place our volunteers and other rescue services at risk to go into that community.
And ultimately, if you stay, you're putting your life at risk as well.
At Liverpool, the SOS went out and the SES answered the call.
I'm entering the water now.
Walking in with rubber dinghies, floating out residents and their pets.
We've had five adults. These three children we're currently taking now and one dog.
Fire and Rescue lending a hand in Fairfield and Cabramatta. But they couldn't get to them all. At Chipping Norton, a couple swimming out of their Audi through the sunroof.
Coming in hot.
Pulled to safety by Angelo Testa in his tinny. The local legend also saved homes from a rogue 15-tonne boat, towing it along Newbridge Road and tying it down.
Another boat broke off its trailer that wasn't meant to be in the water and risk taking out houses. It was just, yeah, it was all happening.
Even coming to the rescue for emergency crews. Locals are being warned not to rush back to their homes if an evacuation order remains in place. With conditions changing quickly, flash flooding can sweep through already saturated suburbs in just minutes. The risk not worth the cost of getting caught out. Car after car left abandoned on Hoxton Park Road in Preston's, telling this cautionary tale. Sophie Upcroft, Nine News.